Hey guys, today I'm gonna be live coding advent of code day 16 in C. Now I've already written this in Python, but the implementation here is pretty hacky and all over the place, so we're gonna make a C version. So we're going to need to include import probably this as well for malloc. So what we have, let's just keep this here actually, what we have is an input that is a packet, so it'll look something, well, it'll be a hexadecimal, but really what we want to do is interpret this bit by bit because of the definition of the packet. So the first three bits of the packet are the version number, the next three bits are the packet type, and then the information that comes after that is either a literal value, or if it was a literal type, or it will be information that refers to an operation type. So let's get this, actually let me have another one of these on my other monitor. So we're gonna want a structure for our packet, and actually let's type that fit as well. So got int version. We also have a type, and now depending on what the packet is, so when we take in the packet we don't really need to keep all of the information. So when I read in an operation, I'm not going to need to be keeping the length type or the length type. All we actually need is the data that the packet refers to. But depending on whether we have a literal or whether we have an operation, that's either going to be so if we have an operation, that's going to be a list of packets. But if we have a literal, that's going to be a literal integer value. So I think what we're going to want here is a union, and we can say either we're going to have an int data if we have our literal value, or a pointer to all of the sub-packets. So I think that'll be our packet type. And actually, if we go up here, the type is a set of things. So 4 is a literal, 0 is a sum, so we want probably an enum for these. You can say enum types. Let's name them like this. this. I got some products. Minimum, maximum, greater than, less than, and equal to. So we can come here and say, I think we can do it like that. I can't remember exactly. God, I hate everything that comes up. I hate tutorials point. I hate Geeks for Geeks. This is a good website though. Say that I want it to be of that type. Just like this, yeah, that's perfect. So now we have a packet, or even this is just preliminary stuff, really. We're gonna want to read in our data and convert that to a binary format. So we could have it as a file read. I'm just going to take it from standard input, though I think be much easier than dealing with file operations. So, if we so, I guess ultimately we want a list of Boolean values. So we say, we're going to take a massive string, you can scanf input. This, so we get the string into this variable. And then we're going to want to convert this to a bit string. So let's just make sure that this is working as I expect it to. Can I see, and of course not, because I did not put a semicolon here or here. Actually, I'm gonna put that there as well. Yeah, I think that's fine. Oh, let's just do that. That's the so once an input reads it back to me. Perfect. So we get this in, and we're going to want to create binary from the, so if we start bits, this is going to be the length of the input, but because every hex character is 4 bits, times that by 4, of course we want it to be character sized, so we can get the bits, allocate this space for that, and then you can say we're going to loop through every single character in the input. And convert it so we can just say can we just do it like bits I times 4 equals, and then we want a function that takes a hex character, returns a switch on X. Well, this is going to be a little tedious. It's probably a better way, but 1 then is this, and let's actually do 0 first. Semicolon. The breaks also need a semicolon. Right, let's to do. Ink 3 lines, paste them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. It's, 2. Do that, and then return bin, and have that as well. Let's just come back up here to 1. this is God, how do I get into insert override? Doesn't really matter that much. Might want to skip past this part because it's just me typing in or counting in binary. Absolutely disastrous if I got any of these wrong, but I think I'll be fine. Okay, so let's not do this. See. Do it like this. Import I. All right. I expect this isn't going to work like I want it to. Yeah. Right, let's just say character pointer. Did I write that? Assignment to expression with array type. Okay. I think we have to mem copy or something. Or we could have all of these just do their own. Place the signature, before. Do that back to the top. Previous, okay, it doesn't like that. String copy, destination, source, slash, so take this lot again, we'll replace bin equals work. Looks like simplage string by age. Function returns address of local variable. Let's actually just have a pointer that it goes to. We'll say that it points into something. We can come down here and can say hex to bin, because we want input I goes into bits plus I times 4. Okay, that compiles, that's good. And then I guess we will actually add one to this. Do that so we can then set the final bit as the terminator. Didn't work. Why not? That's right. So we hex the bin, input I, switch on X, X should not be B. We'll change how we do this, but string copy to bin here. One zero one one break. string copy, copy it. No, that shouldn't be an issue. We print. Bits. Okay, didn't like that. Because of this, I think. Let's do that. Okay, that's looking good. Let's get one of the examples. So come on. D2FE2A. Okay, can't just do that. What? Oh fuck, I over messed up. it's recompile, it's not the arrow, it's so 11 01 0 1 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 1 0 0. Okay, so this is working. We now have our list of bits. This is very good. So we're up to, let me pull the Python program back over. We've read in the input. So now we need a function called getPacket, because the whole input, so for me, this is one packet, but it contains many sub packets. So we're going to have, we don't need to do that, packet getPacket. So, I guess I'll put this up here at the same time, and we can look at that. So, for starters, we're not going to need this I variable, because we'll update the pointer instead. Because we're in C, so we know that the version is going to be the first three bits as an integer, but how are we going to get that? Well, actually, even before we do this, we're going to need some space for a packet. So let's get ourselves that space. And now, basically, the algorithm for reading in something like this, because we don't have all this ability, is we left shift by one and then add. If it's, and we add one, if it's a bit. So how that goes is, so we know we're gonna read in three bits. So we can say I less than three. And then we say if, no, so version, and actually we have to start this off at 0, or it's gonna get fucked. Version left shift 1, if bits I is a 1, then increase version. Let's take this all back. So I think that's how it's gonna go, but because we're gonna do this a bit, we'll do a function for it. So we'll say int into int takes a character pointer, and we also need to know how many characters to read in. We can say it's going to start at 0. The int there is actually not necessary or default to int, but it's useful for more clarity, especially if people don't know that quirk of the language. So version left shift 1, if bits I is a 1, increase version, and then we just return our version, because we are doing a general function now. X 10x, and so down here, instead of all of this nasty shit getting repeated all the time, we can say into int bits 3. And actually, we don't need to do it like this. We can say version. So let's just check this is working for now then. So we've got our bits here. So packet p equals get packet bits. And to check that this is working, we can print the version, check that I got the right version number. So I think just have this recompile, doesn't like it, it's because it's not a pointer this time. Unexpected expression before packets. Right, I thought that was acceptable, but I guess not. Let's try that. Run the program. This is not right, I'm pretty sure, because it's these 3 bits, so it should be 6. So what did we read? Yes, So what's happened here? We start off with 0. And actually, let me check I'm even using left shift right. Left shift properly. Because I don't really do that much. So I feel like this algorithm should work as I know it. Let's go back in the debugger. Break on into int. Okay. X0, I0. Actually, one of these I0s is redundant. We can get rid of that. So let's print bits. So we got the right thing here. So we print bits. I, that's a 1. Where's the left shift? Did that happen? I don't think the left shift is happening. Is this because we need to reassign it? Yes, I would think so. C shift. That doesn't do it in place. This is the same shitty website. Here we go. Left shift. Yeah, okay. So the compiler just got rid of the line because it wasn't doing anything. So that's like, there's no point running it again without recompiling. So 6, there we go, that worked, our function worked. Just gotta be a bit less obtuse next time. So after this, we can increase our pointer by 3 places, because we're done with that now, and we can say that the next 3 bits are the type. We can use our function again. And now we change our code depending on the type. So we'll start with the literal. You can say if the type is a literal, you remember we defined our enum earlier. Type is a literal, then let's open up the documentation. What's this say? Every 5 bits. So we're gonna take 5, and if the first one is 0, then that's the last bit. You can say last is 0. We're not at the last bit yet. Or actually, even we could just say this, and we break out of it when it's done. So now the actually the bit pointer should be incremented by 3 again, and now it's pointing to so we pointed it here to get the start of the next bit, so now it's pointing here. So if bits what we want is to accumulate a value, because the 4 bits are the actual value, but you have to join them all together, which is awkward, but we can say we know there's gonna be just call it lit. We know there's gonna be at least 4 bits. So we can start with this. Actually, yeah. Because we're gonna want to reallocate this. We're gonna want to increase the size every time. So actually, can we say this? It sounds kind of stupid, but and then let me check on realloc. Let me get a normal website pointer new size. That's all there is. So realloc lit, and actually I think oh no, that's all we need to do. New size. Say int size t1 equals 4 reallocate to length. And then for we're gonna have a gonna need to be using loops, so we may as well just have an I up here. For I is 0, I is less than 4, because we're going to go 4 times. Increase I. We say the literal at the point length minus 4 plus I is bits I plus 1. Because we are skipping that first bit. And then if the first bit was a 0, then we break. Is this gonna work? I don't think it is. And for transparency, let's put this here. Well, I mean, we might as well try it. Can't really fuck anything up. This is a literal value. So recompile doesn't like it. Literal undeclared. I don't know. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Remember when I didn't actually write that down there? Let's try it again. Doesn't like it. Okay, so it's a void pointer. That's why. Comparison between pointer and integer. Yes, that would be bad. And actually, we haven't finished this function at all. If it's not, then we need to increase the length by 4. And move bits by 5, and let's close that as well. Doesn't like it. Declaration or statement at end of input 154. Declaration or statement at end of input in function get packet. Ah, because it doesn't return anything yet. It's just return p. I'll dereference it. Okay. I have no idea if that worked. Well, we also haven't done this. Why have I malloced this, even? I don't know. We don't need to do this. We can make this a lot simpler. MP, delete this. Dot value equals enter int of lit and the length. And we also want to free that memory up afterwards as well. Packet has no member named value. What do I call it? Data. Okay, no crashing. Let's print data. Let's compile so it'll print the data. 2021. I think that's right. Yeah. Okay. So that's not too bad. Let's try. Is there any other? I don't think there's any other examples, but that seems like it's working. So let's get working on if it's not a literal. What we know is that there's actually two types of, so the literal takes can have two types of length, and this length is an integer that either refers to a number of packets or to a number of bits that it's going to read in. So we need length types, and if it's 0 is what's a 0? Come on, just bit length or 1 is a sub. We'll call this packet length. So come back down. If the current one of bits equals 0, so let's say length type L, if it's a 0, actually let's switch on this. Switch on bits. If it's a 0, then L is bit length. Take me back down. Bit length. Actually, even we can do it better than this. L is bits minus that. So let's see, that the only real problem we have now is getting the subpackages in. Actually, I'm gonna need a packet count so instead of just having, we actually want another structure in here. Struct packet list just made up of however many sub packets, because we need to keep track of how many sub packets there are. So the I think the only what this L is going to be changing is the looping condition. Otherwise, nothing much else. Let's see, so over here we have, if it's a type 0, then we find the, oh no, it's doing more than that, because they have different they have different bit widths. So a bit length 1 reads in a 15 bit number representing the number of bits. Actually, since do that, we can say int length the length is going to be into int of bits. It's 15 bits we read in if it's a bit length. Otherwise, we don't need to put all of this shit around it, do we? We can just say L equals bit length 15, otherwise 11. The nice little ternary operator. So we get that, and then we have to read in however many sub packets. So what we do in this one is we check that we haven't reached the destination, and in this one we just loop 3 times. And we want to also make sure that we are increasing our point. cutter to the appropriate position. And we can just I equals 0. And the condition, if it's a bit length, is that it doesn't equal bits at the start plus this length, but the other one is that the count increases. And what are we doing in these? So these are the exact same three lines, so we add a new packet, we're recursively calling that, and we're updating the pointer as well. So I think, yeah, because this is finding the length, because I had to store the length of the packets in them in the Python version, although we might have to in this one as well, actually thinking about it. Okay. So let's just go there. Come back here. Now the reason I've not really written anything is because I'm trying to think of something clever to do both of the conditions either way. But let's write the code. We have payload sub packets. And actually this is our type def. Well, not our type def, packet list. We have a group of packets. So there's no thing, I'm guessing, because we haven't put that there. So payload. God, I need another copy of this open. I need to Jesus. I'm line 153. Packet list. Get me back to 153. Payload. Packet list dot length 0. We start with length 0. And well, we'll just write it for final position. If we get bit length, is this plus 15. So while bits doesn't equal the final position, what we want to do is add a sub packet so we can p dot packet list what's it called? Subpackets. Subpackets is a pointer to a list of packets, but there's nothing in it yet. What we want to do is reallocate. This is the harder part, so bear with me, please. I need to get the subpacket. So we're gonna be calling get packet recursively. And the way, so we'll make a new one. List dot length is going to be increased, and when we do that we're going to need more space. So we need to reallocate space from to the size of the length times by size of a packet. Okay, that's a long line. We'll live. Oh god, let's do this. So now we've done that. And now we need to put this new packet there. So we don't need memcpy. What we need is p.packetList.subpackets. We need to set the packet at the index of the length minus one. This is get packet at bits. Yeah, that's the only thing. So we also need to make sure that we increase the bits amount appropriately. So we need to have the length of the packet. So we have two lengths. So when we do this, we're gonna be we need to record the start position. So we can say that the start position is just equal to bits at the start. Where that goes, because here and we need to increase bits by the length of the previous one. Like that, I think. So in theory I've written it in for the bit test. So we can try it with this. Okay, brilliant. No member named packet list. Storage size of L isn't known. Okay, let's start off by fixing that. Declaration does not declare anything. Don't need that, I'm guessing. We don't need that either. Do you mean no semicolon and a structure union? What is the problem? Ah, it's not like type, it's types. Fix that one. Packet has no member named packet list. It is right there. Ah, we need do that, perhaps. Okay. Initialization of int from char star. Okay, no errors, and I have no idea if it worked. I mean, what's it even supposed to output? Prints the bits, the version, and the data. Of course, there is no data because this is not that. What we want is I mean, it didn't crash at least. What we want to do is see what is done. So we need to see if the sub packets add there. So delete this. Oh my god. Printf. Actually, let's just print out how many sub packets there are. See if it gets that right for now. Oh my fucking god, what's going on? Okay, that's not a good sign. Sub packets 0.8. Okay, let's. Step what is L bit length? That is correct. What is length? Oh, it's doing it. Line 15. So we should get 27. Out of this. Can I do this quite a few times? So what do we want? We want the length. 27, that's right. Final point. No, well, that doesn't really mean anything. So bits moves 15 forward, packet list of length is 0. Sub packets is malloc 0. What bits doesn't equal final. We actually need to start what is it? So it's however many. So the final point is plus the +15, but it's plus the length as well. So let's quit this. Segmentation fault. Lovely. Step. Just skip over that. We know that goes right. So final point, increase hits bits, because bits isn't increased yet. So then bits gets increased. So while bits doesn't equal final, increase the packet this length. Yeah. Now I want to get packet bits. So we're now getting the packet. So let's print bits. There is nothing in bits apparently. So this should be reading in this. Something has happened where it's not passing in the pointer properly. Let's set a new breakpoint on 160. Where's bits at this point? 1101000. Okay, so that's good. But then, as soon as we step into here, okay, now this is not working. Zero. That is not right. Six. That is right. Literal. Yes. So then we should do this. Let's this is version 6, type equals literal. Data is 10. The length, we have not set the length, have we? That's gonna be fucking everything up. We can do that right at the end. segmentation for coordinates. God. Break on 160. Six lateral. Yep. Same type is a lateral. So we like four, like this four. Free that p dot length, yes. So like this six apparently, but that is not right. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So that means what does that mean? If we do that, we might be alright. Okay. Break on. Let's just break on 1.2. Maybe it's version 2, right? No. Why has it done that? Why is the version not 2? Okay, no crashing, but still not what we want. This is our final. Length is 11. Data equals 10. does it. This point, I come here, get to this point, so it's not a file yet. Increase the length, reallocate, is reallocate. List length is 2, sub packets. Why is it all zeros? It like that. Length 27. Using the wrong length in here. I want p dot packet list dot. Let's okay, that's the right answer, because that's the that's this, and then the next one should be, and that's just GDB it. It's 0 and 1. You got 10 and a 20, taking up 11 and 16. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Subversion 2. Yep. It's a type 4, which is a literal. Yep, perfect. So we've got the bit count 1. So now it's just a matter of doing the other one, which should be exactly the same, but with a different looping condition. So we can, well, for now, do this. So if L is bit length, do this one. Do something else, and actually we can put this, we can just do that. That's the final point. And then this one, there's already an I in this function, isn't there? So I0 is less than length plus plus I. We're just gonna yank 5 lines. Can I paste that here? And I feel like that'll work. I'll come back and fiddle with this to make it so it's not repeating the same shit, but let's just try this with a packet length 1 now. So compile, run it, packet length 7.1. Yeah, so 1.7 is the the type, because that's what I'm still printing at the bottom. It's actually probably not a good idea to keep printing that, but we get 1, which is perfect. And I imagine if we do the break right at the end, 205. Print p dot packet list dot sub packets 0. We got 1. That's because I did the wrong way around, but yeah, so all correct. So now we've successfully passed it, which is the hard part, at least as far as I'm concerned. But I would like to do better. And actually, this these two should be up here. And I just want to change the loop. The loop types, basically. So what we can do is we can make a loop like this, I guess, for I equals 0, and then I'm gonna say L is bit length. So if we do this, if it's a bit length, then we want to check bits doesn't equal final. Otherwise, we want to check I is less than length. Not very pretty, but we'll do, I think. And then, like this. Things don't need this, don't need any of that. So I think that should save us on that. Yeah, looks like it's working. I'll try it with the this one. Yep, cool. So now we have our data structure. This is basically we've interpreted all of the data and we know everything. If we go to the second part, now what we need to do is we need to use this structure to work out an expression. That's it, it represents an expression. So what we're going to do is we have, so those are the types, and now what we have is all of these refer to operations, which each have the type that they belong to, and they each have a function that they use. So it's something like this. Actually, this needs to come beneath the definition for packets, because going to take a packet. So I think like that. We're going to use function pointers instead of switches. And actually, we don't need a struct. We just need a array. Let's here. This is a nice trick with an enum. To get the length just by sticking that at the end, because it counts up. So okay, so we have an int operators. This is a packet. Keep the types close by, just so they don't get all mixed up. Oh, No, we can't do that because they are the packet relies on them. So we'll just have to make do like this. So anyway, what we need to do is write all of these functions, and this is actually so now other stuff is going to need a packet list, because all of these are going to take a packet list. So how do I do that when it's going to be recursive back and forth? Let's just say it takes a pointer and a length. So we can have our accumulator is 0, four. I is going to start 0. I needs to increase the number of times we have. We just say the accumulator plus equals that packet dot data. No. Yes. What do we do over here? We have a sum, and what does it get called? Operators. In evaluate. Let's come back to this and start writing the evaluate function instead, because that will help it make more sense in my head. So evaluate a packet. We if type. If it's a literal, then of course the value is just data. Otherwise, what we need to do is we need to get the operators at p.type, and that needs to take and evaluate to packet. So this is going to take because we need to do all of the sub things. We can't just make a list like this. We need to otherwise, okay, so the count is going to be p dot packet list dot length. And then we want to packets values is so this is going to be the list of evaluate values. is an array of the number of values we're going to need times the size of an integer, and then say for i0 I is less than the number of things that the value at I is evaluate packet of p dot packet list dot sub packets I. So that's going to do it recursively. It gets all of the values below it, so you can think of it grouping stuff together like that, and then because we're going to need to free this, we int turn value is operators type, and it's going to take all of the values and the number of values. We need to free that memory up, return the return value. So if we go find our operators again, so we have a sum. It doesn't take packets. What it takes is just integers. So like that, I think. So for here, I think we can just say sum, because I mean we're gonna name them now. We want sum, we want product, minimum, maximum, it's nothing for that one. In here we used a dictionary, but that would be a real fucking pain for this. Would also be nice if we had lambda functions. That's the one thing I think C could do with. Okay, so this is our list. We can change this to int pointer int. So we got sum. It's about sum. It's about product. I wrote code. I'm no faggot. I don't know. Products. Basically the same. I mean, we could abstract a whole nother layer of operators and write a reducer function, but that might be a bit, I don't know, would be funny, but not today. I don't think it really warrants a reducer function right now. I should have copied and pasted this code. It's only accumulator, okay. Sum product. Minimum. Did I just call it min? No, I didn't. So, let's see. Int x. Now, let's see. So this is going to equal the first one. Actually, let's do it. This in I is 1. Actually, so for I equals 1, I is less than length increase I if p I less than x, x is p I return x. Okay, that's our minimum. We can copy that and get a maximum if we just swap out that character, min, max, greater than and less than. So these just take the first and second. So these are actually really simple. We don't even need to bother with a lot of stuff. We can just say return p 0. This isn't maximum. This is greater than. Just say that. Yank all of those. Less. Come on. Right. Do that. That's less than. And equal to, of course, is also basically exactly the same. Equal to that. So I can't remember what I've done. Let's just run it. Okay, let's not just run it. I think I don't need all of those ands. Let's and excess elements in scalar initializer. We will sort that out in a bit. W undeclared. Expected. Scripted value is pointer to function. Is it? Operators declared as a function returning an array. Here, so we need the square brackets there, I think. No errors. Brilliant. I can say result is evaluate. Printf. Result. What's this? That's not it. Let's get an example. This should give me 3. It does. This should give me 54. It doesn't. So let's see why it does not give me 54. So P, we've got a product. Yes. So the count is the packet list length. Should be 2, yes. So, that'll be the packet. So now we've got a literal. So, 6, yes. And then get that. So, print values. Zero and one. Get 6 and 9. So print p dot type is product. Insert into product. I just less than length, yes. Okay. Product needs to where is it? Let's actually keep the formatting correct on slash in. Space should be in new line instead. That is not what I wanted. Also not what I wanted. Let's do it by hand then. But the reason that it's not working is because product is starting at zero, and of course anything times zero is just zero. No matter if you start multiplying all sorts of stuff, you actually need to start it at the first one. So p 0 I starts up. I need to start up at 1 instead. So let's quit that. Now let's recompile. Yes, and let's go down here and get rid of this, it's annoying me. So, now this one's working, should get 9, perfect. Can I see a 15? No. No, we don't want 15, we want 1, which is correct. Can I see a 0? Yes. Can I see another 0? Perfect. Ooh. Absolutely I can. Let's go. So I guess we may as well try this on the full input then. So mind you, the full input looks like this. I don't have a copy of it in this directory, so I'll just copy it from the Python and then just to show you that it's there. And the result we are looking for is 158 135 423 448. Fuck. Stack smashing detected. Well, isn't that just brilliant? Copy this, run from the beginning, stack smashing detected. Where is the stack smashing? Where does it happen? Are we making it to the well, it prints all the bits. Does it get the P? So got P. instead of .p. So let's so something's gone wrong in the evaluation. Packet run this. So it's not a literal. Actually, let's put some 5,423, which it sounds like the length of this. You can check that pretty quickly. Oh, but it's been int x. Should be a multiple of 4, I'm pretty sure, actually. So is it? So we get let's show this again. So it's come up with the wrong thing. 001. It's added 2 zeros to the start. So that means the issue isn't with the evaluation where the stack smashing occurs. The issue is actually in the reading it in. It's in the turning it into hexadecimal even in the first place. So we want to come down here, I guess line 269. Command even run so that's the bits print bits nothing yet. While input I Oh, I know those two zeros are probably right actually, because the we want 0010 for 2. So get 0010. But the length is, where's the length going up like that then? So let's because it should be one packet. I mean that's actually one more than the length of the packet, because this bin is including a 0b at the start. What we want is to do this 5422, not 5423, 5422. sure actually then. Continue. So bits. Guess maybe we'll go to evaluate packet. Continue. There's 53 values inside, apparently. And we can see what the Python version says. Documents, programs. What's this dude doing? Should we evaluate the packet P? Or a print P? Let's see it say. Evaluation. Because it's caps. So this is version type ID length. Five, four, two, three is the length, and this is the sub things, which could well be 53, I guess. So evaluate one of the sub packets. There's a data. What is stack smashing something? Overflow. Probably something wrong with one of the operator functions, I think. this little, does it, right. So the last thing it does is it tries to do a zero, and a zero is a sum. And it doesn't like that. It's going out of bounds somewhere. Return value, and that's not really useful because so it gets to this point and it smashes the stack. In main. So we exited. That doesn't sound right. Same thing. I have no idea what the fuck is going on now. Does it make it to like 286? Then it crashes at the end. I think that might not be big enough. So let's try move this along. Why is this stack smashing after the program runs? That doesn't make any sense. Because the input is so big. That would make sense, I guess. This stuff getting this. Where am I? you mean that? Brownish piece of shit. Save! Stop doing this. Write the file. Fucking hell. So. So it looks all right, I guess. That is this really just it's really annoying. So it looks like it's working for the most part. Actually, what if I get rid of this? We can need to recompile. Say all of this. I just want this space there. Yes, there shouldn't be negative values, so stuff is getting too big. So let's, I guess we've got to make stuff long, so I guess the easiest way to do this would be just to take int, make it all long, and see if that works. Pro long F. Pro. Long F. Print F. So where, so, 6. Is this too big for a long? is going on here then? Okay. So. It gets to here, and then suddenly we get a negative value. Also if you want. Search for 16 120 So this is coming from a sum. So we'll break sum run. Not that. Take that. Okay. So I think that's one apparently. So we got this one, then this one. So 7, the next one's 28, 26, 22, 6, so. Okay, so we're moving on to our problem. In here, so print p 0, very big number, very small number, it's not as small. So that's all of them. So add all these together, I mean 6, 4, 7. Seems about right. So what's going on here? Next. So now it's this. So what's the problem? Why is something ridiculous getting returned? For the values. creative. And then we get this negative number. In fact, we never see this 5, so where did that come from? A few times. That's a 21, so here I think it's actually this is 11 still. Now 1968 34 28 31 17. What happens here? Because this is the last one. So that's the right number. So what is going on? So I was waiting for the full line to do it, but where? Oh, fuck me, it's... So the longs are red, but we weren't outputting correctly, so... Let's leave it at that. This is what I think anyway. Jesus, fuck off with your stupid block. Just tell me what they are. I want a long, 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 so L, I, so flags. That's not right. It's where's the thing gone? Length type, so LD like that. Okay, so now it gives the right answer. We've still got this stack smashing issue, and I don't know what that's about, but I don't think it's my fault that much. Anyway, this is the right answer, as we can see here. So that's good. Maybe we can look through all of the longs and change what needs to be a long and what doesn't. So that doesn't need to be a long. That doesn't need to be a long. That might do. Got these. And keep going down here. Just say send S long I and I all of our I's can be integers. Length, I think, can be an integer. Already gone past this bit. And main should probably just be an integer since it's not even returning anything. And compile that. That's not what I want. Now this works. This works. So I guess I'll add this to my key repository. If you wanna tell me what the fuck is the deal with my stack smashing, I would really like that. So yeah, thanks for watching. I need took about 2 hours longer than I thought it would. But I'll link to my stuff in the description. Thank you. See you.